Hello, statistics students, and welcome to Statistics with JASP for Beginners. These videos are intended for people who want to become familiar with JASP and learn how to use it for statistical analysis. I'm going to begin by showing you around the JASP workspace. So open JASP on your computer and we will get started. JASP opens to this lovely welcome screen, or splash page. Now there's not much to see yet. There's an option to load more modules. Some icons that have been dimmed. And this pancake stack, which is the main menu icon. Now by way of getting introduced, click on this About option. Here you see the most current version of JASP, version 0.12. Now, chances are that when you look at your own computer, whatever version number you see is going to be different than what you see here. And that is because JASP is still being developed at breakneck speed, and it is continually adding new features in updates. Now, this ongoing development is nothing to be concerned about. I am going to be showing you the most stable features, so what you learn here will apply with later versions. However, when JASP issues an update, as long as you are connected to the internet, you will be notified that a new version is available. Click to open the JASP website and download the version appropriate to your operating system. Now, if you are a statistics student, chances are very good that in the near future you will create, collect, inherit, or be gifted some data of your very own. And that data may come in one of multiple formats. Well, I just so happen to have some datasets right here on my desktop. Let's open one of them. In the main menu, click on Open. And you will see that we have four options for opening data. Begin with the computer. I have files on the desktop. Try opening this Excel file. It does not work. You see, Excel files are troublesome for a number of reasons. So if you use Excel to collect your data, be sure that you save your data to the desktop as a comma-separated values or .csv file. JASP can also open a dat file. You can open datasets that were created by the popular SPSS program. These files are saved as a .sav file. The advantage to using SPSS files is that JASP will import all of the variable and value labels. If you do not have SPSS installed on your computer, you will not be able to see the icon, but you will still be able to open the SPSS dataset. Because we have now opened a dataset from the desktop, any recently used datasets will appear in the Recent Files panel. If you move your data to another folder on your computer, however, JASP will have trouble finding it. So I recommend keeping a special folder, perhaps in your computer documents folder, for all of the files that you receive in your stats course. Now this option is interesting, OSF. That stands for the Open Science Framework. OSF is a project where you can upload, download, share actual research data, and you can collaborate with others on research projects. Anyone can create a free OSF account. And if you do not have one, I'd encourage you to get one. Or at least check out the website to see what it can do. There's one more type of file that we're interested in. The example datasets that come pre-installed in the JASP data library. So let's review how we got here. We started with main menu, open, data library. So to make our lives easier, JASP gives us plenty of example datasets to use. And these datasets are organized by the type of analysis for which they are most suitable. Now you may ask yourself, where do these datasets come from? And you may tell yourself, I bet Andy Field has something to do with this. And you would be right. Same as it ever was. Many of these datasets come from two statistics textbooks. Andy Field's Discovering Statistics Using IBM SPSS Statistics and Introduction to the Practice of Statistics by Moore, McCabe, and Craig. If you are using either of these textbooks in your stats class, then you will read about these datasets in your text. But regardless, all of us can still open, use, save, modify these datasets, with the caveat that data, like other original works, is protected by copyright. So enough talk. For this to be any fun at all, we need some data. Now, because we're exploring the workspace, it doesn't really matter which dataset we open. So let's use this dataset at the bottom of the list, debug dataset. This view will look familiar to anyone who has ever used Excel, SPSS, or any other spreadsheet program. These, of course, are the raw data. You can scroll through your data in any direction. Up, up, down, down, left, right, left, right, B, A. You can grab the top bar to move the panel around on your desktop. The entire panel can be resized as well. Now, our data are presented in a set of rows and columns, not unlike we would see in Excel or in SPSS. Now, of course, as we proceed, we may need to edit something about these data points. Perhaps we want to correct one of the values. Let's change this first participant number from number 1 to number 1000. Double-click on this data point to select it for editing. We are presented with a dialog box explaining that this is a read-only data file. And in order for us to edit, we need to find the file on our computer or generate a new one. So you see, the data sets that are included with JASP are locked down and cannot be edited. Therefore, we need a version that we can edit. Click on Generate Data File. Save the new file to our desktop. When you do, the CSV opens. CSV stands for comma separated values, and it will likely open in Excel unless you have some other spreadsheet program that you use. Now, from this point forward, you will be able to edit the data in Excel. Change the first participant number to 1000, flip back to JASP, and notice that this change has not been recorded. We need to save all changes in Excel. And now we see it reflected in JASP. Okay, let's do one more thing. Click on the main menu icon, Save As. Computer, desktop, and save it as debug. The data have been saved to the desktop in a new format, the JASP file format. Now, this file format saves our data, any analyses that we run, and the results. So this will be your workflow. When you collect data, import your data from the CSV or other file format, but save it as a JASP data file. And do all further analyses in that JASP data file. Double-click on data points to edit them in a CSV, but then save them back into JASP. So most of the excitement in JASP is going to take place in these two panes. On the left, we have the analysis pane. And on the right, we have the results pane. As you can see, I have already done an analysis and I'll have the results visible. This is our first view of the JASP progressive disclosure. Any adjustments that we make in the analysis pane appear immediately in the results pane. All of the analyses are organized within these icons. Each new analysis is added below the most recent analysis. Click on Descriptives. This opens a new pane. All we need to do is enter some variables. There are three ways to move a variable into the analysis panel. Number one, click and drag. Click on the binomial variable and drag it into the variables panel. Number two, the triangle. Click on the ordinal variable, factor 5, and then click on the right-facing triangle between the panels to move this variable into the variables panel. You can also move it out of the variables panel this same way. And C, double-click. Double-click on the continuous variable normal and move it into the variables panel. Now that we have nominal, ordinal, and scale variables, let's add a nominal text variable. Select the gender variable and move it into the variables box in the way that you like best. With each new variable, notice the new results added to the original table in the results pane. Again, this is called progressive disclosure. I would like this nominal text variable to be right next to the nominal variable. Simply drag it below the nominal variable. Notice the changes to the table. Now, three of these variables are nominal or ordinal, so click on the frequency table option. Notice that we get three new frequency tables, one for each nominal or ordinal variable, but not for the scale variable. You can also notice the differences between the type of information that JASP provides automatically for each type of variable. Because we set the level of measurement, JASP knows exactly what to do with our data. Click the disclosure triangle next to plots. Now, without explaining all of these options, I can simply click on them to see what they do. A quick note about terminology here. Now, in Europe, you might say that we tick or untick the boxes. In America, we check and uncheck them. I'll probably move back and forth between those two terms. You will notice that some of these plots look like they might mean something, and others do not. Some plots run only on the categorical variables and not on the scale variable. The important thing to know here is that you cannot mess up the analysis. If a plot doesn't look right, you can simply turn it off. Untick that box. Now click or tick the disclosure triangle next to statistics. We are presented with a variety of options. What do they all mean? Maybe you could use some help. Scroll to the top of the analysis and click on the blue letter I. Here we see all of the available options, along with a description of what they do. Now, this box can be an ever-present help in times of statistical trouble. Go ahead and close the help box. What are the other options? The black pencil allows us to edit the title of this analysis. That can be very useful when running multiple analyses. The green plus sign duplicates an analysis. I love to use this when I'm building regression models. And the red X removes the analysis completely. The disclosure triangle next to the analysis name hides or shows the current analysis. If you select Other Analyses, the Results window scrolls to the top of that window. And what about our data? Where did our numbers go? Well, they are still right here. Tick the disclosure triangle to show them. Holding the part of the bar with the three dots allows you to slide and adjust the panes. The triangles almost always work to show or hide a pane in its entirety. Any changes that you make to the value labels will then be reflected in the tables in the results pane. So we should wrap up this video with one last skill. We made some changes to that debugging data set that came pre-installed with JASP. Click on the main menu icon. Save. Now quit JASP by clicking on the red circle or the red X, depending upon your operating system. Later, when we reopen our debug data set, not only the data, but also all of the work that we have done have been saved for us. So this has been a thorough introduction to the JASP Workspace. Next time, we will learn an important skill for handling data, beginning by setting variables in JASP.